Hi everyone. So now I am starting with the next numerical, that is sphere numerical. So here in this question figure you can notice two identical spheres, right? So now we'll read out the question. Two identical rollers each of weight 500 newton. See, two identical rollers each of weight 500 newton are supported by an inclined plane making an angle of 30 degrees, right? So it is supported by an inclined plane of 30 degrees to the horizontal and a vertical as shown in the figure. Sketch the free body diagrams of the two rollers. So they are telling us to sketch the free body diagram first. And assuming smooth surfaces, find the reactions at the support. So they are telling us to get the reactions also. Okay. So this is the question. So the hint they have given is the weight, right? And it is said that it has been like 30 degrees difference from normal, like from the flat surface to the inclined surface, we have 30 degrees difference, okay? And where the reaction will be produced means reaction is the forces produced in the contact points, okay? In the contact points only you will get the values of the reactions. So where is the contact points for the spheres means at A point, B point, C point and D point. So there are four contact surface. Four contact surface means there are four reactions will be there, right? First we shall see how to draw FBD for this, right? Just draw the two rollers here. So it is said that there are like a weight of 500 newton is hanging over the sphere 1 and sphere 2. So just mark this 500 newton and 500 newton for sphere 1 and sphere 2. Consider one as sphere 1 and other sphere as sphere 2. And now just draw the reactions wherever we will get the contact points. Wherever we will get contact points means, see this RA. RA means like opposite to that of RA, this A point and again B point and in this D also you can observe, right? So in the D point you can observe reaction and in the C point you can observe reactions, right? So these are the four contact points and these are the reactions you will be finding, right? Now we'll see how to draw the free body diagram for this one. Okay, just draw the particular axis for the sphere 1 and sphere 2. Just give some distance between them. Why they have plotted 30 degrees directly means from the normal axis to the inclined axis the difference is 30 degrees, right? So they have taken directly as 30 degrees, right? So so just draw whatever the known force you have. See this RA, it's directly in the horizontal axis. Let it go out as per the principle of transmissibility. In the line of action you can transfer the forces, and 500 newton is hanging over here. This RB, like you can just transfer it to the graph in the line of action. This transfer it and the difference is 30 plus 30, 60 degrees. And again RD is facing in this side, right? So for RD also same concept. Again for the sphere 2, 500 newton is hanging down and this RD is like in this axis it comes down. Just draw it. And RC is facing like RC, see it is like facing little like but it's not in the vertical axis. Just put it in the line of action and just transfer it, so you will get in the above face and the difference is 30 plus 30, 60 degrees. And above below also, see every the difference between one angle to the other angle will be 30 degrees, since the difference between the normal axis and the inclined axis is 30 degree for this case. So the for every each and every angle transmission it is applicable. So this is the free body diagram for the entire system. So now we shall see how to solve the numerical. Before that I will let you know one thing. Okay, let this RD one force, let it come this side and make it as a 3-4 system, so that one force will be known for you, other two forces unknown for you, right? But in this sphere it is not applicable. Why means, see 500 newton, okay, it's a known force. RA, RD, RB, three unknown forces, it's not possible with Lami's concept, because Lami's concept always says that sine of force is proportional to the sine of angle between other two forces. So that is not applicable for this particular system, right? So you need to do only equilibrium conditions for this particular figure, okay? And now, so see, by applying the Lamy's theorem in the ball too, as I said, in the first ball it is not applicable, right? So so in the ball too, you can see one 500 newton, one RD comes up, and one RC, right? This only these three forces will be there, and the angle between them is, you know, the one force to other force is 30 degree. So 30 and 60, right? 90 degrees, and this is 30 and this is 60. Right, again for ball one also they have drawn FBD first, but they will find answers only for like ball two. Okay, for ball two, sine of one force is proportional to the sine of angle between other two forces. So 500 divided by sine of 90, RC divided by sine of 90 plus 30, and RD divided by sine of 90 plus 60. Okay. So they will find the answer for RC and RD. Now by substituting this in the ball 1, okay, by substituting it, see in the equilibrium there are now 4 forces. So for this 4 forces, like like you can watch 4 forces. Lamy's is not applicable here because Lamy's is a theorem that is applicable only for 3 force systems. So you can go for equilibrium condition. Equilibrium condition means summation of horizontal forces and summation of vertical forces. You have one direct vertical force, direct horizontal force, but two inclined force. That can be resolved into two forces, right? So 2 plus 2, 4, 5, 6 forces. In this 6 forces, 3 forces are horizontal, 3 forces are vertical. Just assemble it, and as per graph you can take the sign. So you will get the answer for RA and RB. Okay, because RD we already would have found using this ball 2 concept in the Lamy, using Lamy's concept, right? So using that, find this RB and RD, and by substituting these things you will get even RA. Finally, the reactions RA, RB, RC and RD is been found. Okay, whatever you have found in the ball 2, that same RD you can use for ball 1 while doing the numerical. So finally you will get all the unknown forces. So this is how you need to solve sphere numerical. Okay, the only thing you have to do is angle transmission should be done correctly. Whatever the angle they have given with respect to inclined axis and normal axis, that same transmission should be used to the all over figure, right? So in my next video I will be explaining few more numericals. Thank you all for listening this.